Today we're going to see if transmission fluid can clean the inside of this car's engine. Now this engine has 270,000 kilometers on it and has been neglected over its time with very infrequent oil changes with really cheap oil. Now they say that transmission fluid has some detergents inside and it can clean the inside. So we're going to take a look under the valve cover and inside of the oil pan to see what difference this makes. And I'm just draining out that old oil. And here's what it looks like under the valve cover. It's all black and tarnished. And here's a look underneath the oil pan. It's actually not too bad. There's nothing really clogging up the oil screen pickup or anything. Even the inside of the oil pan's not too bad. I don't see any built up sludge or metal particles floating around. I'm also gonna take out the old stinky oil filter that was in there and change it out for a brand new one so we could see exactly what comes out from the transmission fluid. And just spin on that new one. You can see how gunked up the bottom of the oil cap is. All right, next up I'm gonna use just some generic automatic transmission fluid. No need anything expensive here. And pour 4 or 5 quarts into the engine. And we're between the two marks on the dipsticks, we got just enough to run this engine. And now we're gonna start the engine. I'm actually quite surprised. There's no knocking or any weird sounds. The engine sounds normal. And I don't see any of it leaking down at the bottom here. So we're gonna let the car idle for about 20 minutes or so. Now you don't want to drive the car with just ATF alone in the crankcase because obviously it's not the best of lubricants. And now we're draining out all that old transmission fluid from the oil pan. And here I've got the valve cover popped off after the automatic transmission fluid flush. The front cover itself looks a little bit better, but the engine itself doesn't seem like there's much difference. It's still pretty black in here. Got a lot of tarnish and a lot of the metal components. Even some of these components here where there's some deposits. If I use my wife's old toothbrush here, I can try to scrub them off, but they're not really coming off and I don't really see a visual difference up the top here. And here's a look at the engine oil pan after the transmission fluid flush. Now visually it doesn't look that much different than before the flush, but if I come in with my wife's old toothbrush here, I notice that a lot of this stuff tends to dissolve when I just give it a quick scrub. So I feel like maybe the transmission fluid is in fact doing something to break down some of those deposits. Now I don't see any solid particles of sludge or anything sitting inside the oil pan, so it hasn't dissolved enough to actually put chunks of sludge down into the oil pan here. Now we're gonna take a look at the color change that happens in the transmission fluid once you do the flush. Now of course new transmission fluid is bright red and nice and clean, and here we have the used transmission fluid after a 20 minute flush. You can see its color has changed to more of a dark brown kind of color, and that's because it's mixed with the engine oil and not because it's actually absorbed any particles or debris in the engine to change that color. Now as a comparison to that flushed transmission oil, I have the actual engine oil that came out of this engine, and who knows how long it's been in there. You can see that it's actually a very dark brown used oil kind of color, whereas the transmission fluid still has a bit of a lighter shade to it. And finally we're going to take a look at the actual transmission fluid that came from the transmission of the same vehicle. Again, who knows how long it's been in there. And you could see, yes, it is used, but its brownish color is more of a reddish brownish color, whereas the flush fluid, which has been contaminated with engine oil, is more of a goldish brown color. Now obviously none of these tests are scientific, but make sure you subscribe if you want to see more videos just like this one. Now I'm going to take a look inside these oil filters to see if it's caught any particles from the transmission fluid. I'm just going to grab my old bed sheet here and wipe up this mess. I'm going to pull this filter apart here, see if we see any debris or particles. And here we have the results of the filter. Now you can see on the outlet side, of course, it's fairly clean. Obviously, as you expect, it was only a 20 minute run. But on the inlet side, you can definitely see that there's a few black dots and speckles and particles that were caught in this filter during this 20 minute fluid flush. So you can definitely tell that this filter has done its job to catch some of these smaller little particles that were broken down possibly by just the transmission fluid itself. Just for comparison, I'm going to cut open the oil filter that was on the vehicle before the flush. This filter is built a lot stronger than that other filter that I put on for the flush. And you could see with the filter that was on here just how much crap is actually lodged inside of this filter here. It definitely needed to be changed, and it was doing its job. So make sure you change your filter, guys, when you're doing your oil change. Now in case you were wondering, I did take apart this engine, and you can see that the top of these pistons are completely covered in a thin layer of carbon buildup. And here's what the rest of the engine looks like. Now the engine head doesn't look too bad, just the valves have a little bit of carbon buildup. The head, of course, is tarnished black, and the engine block itself is in pretty good shape. You can see that the cylinder bores are pretty clean, and it has been well lubricated. It's actually still coated with a layer of oil. Now overall, flushing your engine with transmission fluid gives you really marginal results. If you leave that transmission fluid in there longer, or if your engine is in worse condition, you might get better results. Make sure you follow me on Instagram for more behind the scenes footage, and subscribe for more videos just like this one.